Alright guys, so I'm just having lemonade here at a coffee shop, and I'm finishing up, I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm finishing up a question somebody sent me about where am I at with the radio stuff. And I shared I had just read a couple books, Melissa Odin's book, and then Saying Yes, Beyond Yes, right? And how I want to see the pro-life movement expand. Because again, if we have women saying yes to pregnancy, we need to help her all the way up. And I also want to see women compensated for their time. It is very time consuming to heal from abortion. So I want to see programs in place where women do not have to work and they can have the extra time to heal. If we really want women healthy, we really want to help them in every single way to be their best. So as I'm going through this, I had shared about my grandmother who had raised 10 kids in the projects and how my mother was in an orphanage. And you know, how important it was. My grandmother had a lot of boyfriends around, and how that leaves, especially girls, very vulnerable. Not just kids, but girls. You know, you want a man around to protect you from other men, but those same men can leave, especially, you know, my mother, from what I understand, was a pretty good looking, you know, young woman. And my aunts were too. And so you are opening the door for, you know, the vulnerability of the girls in this type of lifestyle. So I just think, you know, imagine if there was help. Imagine what that would have looked like. The other thing is I had aunts in the country who were very isolated, and one of them got pregnant outside of wedlock. And she had this child, but she was shamed for having a child outside of wedlock. So, you know, they didn't take it out on the child. The child was treated well, but she was not. So I cannot imagine living with that kind of shame, right, all your life. I don't know what happened to her. This is my Aunt Mary from Deerfield. I have no idea what happened to her. So once, she was coming to our house a lot, and then, I mean, at one point she had her head shaved, and she was, you know, working in Hooks It, and all this stuff was going on with her. So if we could have, you know, my passion is to help women. That is my passion, for them to say yes to have the children, and then to have the help all the way up that they need, and help with it all.